else. What do you like to do with scrap wood? Do you like to eat it? Chew on it? Make a planter? That's what we're gonna do. Hey everyone, welcome to Handmade. I'm Liz. I love a good DIY project, but you know what I love more? Saving all those little parts and pieces that are left over from a project and figuring out what to turn them into next. If you do any woodworking projects, you know what I'm talking about. There's always half a board over here or a chunk of wood over here, and you think that could definitely be turned into something. So today, I went into my scrap pile and found this really cool piece of pine. You can see the really pretty wood grain here. And I think that this would be the perfect wood to use for today's project, which is a geometric air plant holder. The great thing about this project is that you can use up really small pieces of wood and create a really unique look for your geometric planter. So without further ado, I've got my safety glasses. Let's get over to our power saw for the first step. The first step is to square up any edges on your scrap wood if you need to. This piece has a split on one end, so that needs to go. If you're using salvaged wood like I am, make sure to double check that any old nails are gone before cutting. To make these planters, we'll need two squares of wood. You can use the width of the scrap piece as your guide to get a perfect square. Mark it with a pencil and let's head back over to the saw. This wood is about 2 inches thick, so I only need two squares for my planter. But if you're working with a 1 inch thick piece of wood, cut 4 squares total. Once the squares are cut, it's time to glue them together. You can rotate the squares of wood to alternate the grain or leave them in line. It really just depends on the look you're going for and what the wood grain of your scrap wood looks like. I'm using a quick setting wood glue plus this handy silicone brush I picked up. You can use any paintbrush, but this one is great because you can pull any dried glue bits out really easily. Spread the glue evenly, but don't put as much near the edges to avoid glue drips. You'll probably need less glue than you think. Once it's glued, add your clamps. Depending on the size of your planter, you'll need 2 to 3 clamps to really get a strong bond. Let this dry completely before moving on to the next step. Okay, the glue is dry and it's time to cut the geometric edges of the planter. Now, if you have a vise, this is the time to use it. Since I don't, I'm clamping the block to my work surface, which also works well. I'm using a push-pull saw because it's a little more flexible than your standard hand saw, which makes it easier to get clean cuts. Starting at an angle, saw off the corner of the square. This definitely takes some elbow grease, especially to get your cut started, but then it goes pretty quickly. Once one cut is done, rotate the square and do it all over again, changing the angle each time for a fun geometric look. As you can see, this is really highlighting the wood grain. I'm also using the angled cutting feature of my miter saw to create a second planter. I started with 2 squares of wood like the first one, but then cut each side at a 15 degree angle. If you try this approach, you'll need to measure each piece as you go to get the perfect cuts. Once both planters are dry, it's time to drill the air plant hole. Now, these don't use soil like your standard plant, so all we need is a small hole. For that, I'm using a wood boring bit. The size you need will vary based on the size of the planter and your air plants, but mine is 3/4 of an inch. We're finally done with our cuts and it's time to sand. I'm using a medium grit paper to clean up rough spots. You could use an orbital sander, but I really want to keep the edges sharp, so I'm just using the sandpaper to knock off uneven spots and any areas that weren't cut during the planter making process. When you're satisfied with the sanding job, it's time to bring in your block oil. It was getting dark, so I started to apply it with my hands for some reason, but a rag works much better. I love how this changes the color of the planters and really brings out that beautiful wood grain. Now just find the perfect spot for the planters and add your air plants. These are watered by soaking them in a sink once a week, so I'll never be pouring water onto these. Pretty cool, right? You'll want to place them in bright indirect light for best results. It was great to use up pieces of my scrap wood pile to make this project, and there's so many different variations you can do. I can't wait to try a few different configurations of wood and cuts. Let me know in a comment below, what do you do with your scrap wood? I still have a pretty big pile left, so I am taking suggestions. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Handmade for more DIYs like this. I'll see you next time. Bye!